So what time is it, Jason?
You're the star of Laura's new video.
It's 9:05. And you know what that means.
That's Angie behind the pillow.
Okay.
Trying to hide. Me?
Do you have a coat hanger for him?
No, why? You're gonna perform. Just show me the dinosaur. Then why do you carry around that dinosaur, Jason?
Because it's just a good thing to carry around. St. Louis?
You're from St. Louis?
Yeah, Stay Fresh crew and Superstars of Love right here.
Was the party good last weekend?
Yeah, the party was wonderful.
Oh, you heard about it?
A lot of people came down. You should come check out St. Louis.
Yeah, man.
It was a very peaceful scene.
Really? Will you come to our next one, May 13th and 14th, the whole weekend? Meet you out with Yato and Reese. Question or something. It's a purpose.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
So where did you like come from?
I'm from Racine, Wisconsin.
From where?
Racine.
Racine, Wisconsin?
Yeah.
And why did you come here?
I came here just to get away from everything, to relax for a week. I get away from work and all the time, you know, working 50-hour weeks. And just to come and zone out on everybody and just be you, you know?
Having a good time?
I'm having a great time.
That's good. Even though the mud and the cold.
Huh?
Where did you stay tonight? Or last night?
I stayed in my buddy's car.
Oh, you stayed there?
I'm famous. I am the hardcore prophet of the world. Hail the DJ Ten Bear.
Hey, bring that camera over here. Look, I want to show you something.
Look at all these bones right here.
Human bones.
Human.
Someone didn't survive the cold night.
Just kind of like wrap them around it, like so we get like a just finger line.
Where are you gonna put this?
It would be really cool. You could put like one on the side, so you could have like lines.
Wait, between these two. Wait.
Yeah, between those.
No, two this stick right here. It's the same height. So we can like go like this. Put bones in and then the flag will be through. Yeah, no one will mess it.
Your own cold.
So how are you doing? Do you like this? Were you here yesterday?
Yes, I was.
Alright.
When did you guys get here?
Yesterday, around 6, I think.
Is it a good time?
Yeah, it's cool. I just wish they'd get more sound. Hi.
Hi.
Man.
Do you know her?
No.
No? Is she giving me something? Recovered?
Uh-huh.
Feeling yeah, better today?
Where'd you guys go?
The cafe in like Hickston.
Oh, that's such a good idea.
It was so good.
You got cafe. My keys, right?
Cool. You need some more party time. Okay guys, we're gonna start staying together, or whoever wants to answer this question.
What question?
What would you define a rave as being, and why?
Bad question, bad time. That's... standing in front of a fire, just kind of giggling. Yeah.
No, seriously, Anthony.
Giggling. A whole bunch of people doing the same thing because they want to, and not giving a shit what anyone else thinks. It's glamour, baby, glamour.
The whole thing on free.
Anyone else?
It's all
no
about.
Comment.
We're not defining it.
I'm not.
Okay, why do you go? Maybe that'd be an easier question.
Well, usually it's to get away from all the fucking interviews I have to do, but now I get this shit here. You know.
What is that?
Whoa, it's the media, man. Just run for it, man. It's the media. We're scared. They're scaring us.
Remember the media talk we had?
Yeah, it was like everyone part of the, or every like bit is the media, and yeah, that was fun. You can't get away from it, so. Shut
just
up.
Accept it.
Well, no, do you think the media has treated you guys fairly, though?
No.
Okay, and
well,
why?
Well, I think some of the shit that we've done, we deserve to be, like,
yelled at.
We should have our
like wrists. Stealing plastic E's off of Dairy Queen's son.
No, I don't just that was fun.
No, that was styling. That was good.
But I got caught. I don't want to talk about that. Anyway.
Convicted rave felon.
Yeah, I know, dude. It's only a regional misdemeanor. Oh,
so
wow.
Like
candy.
Yeah, thank you. So, you think you've been misrepresented in the media?
What?
Unrepresented almost, though. I don't know. Not truly represented. It's so misrepresented that.
Okay, in what way?
Well, I don't know. I love the episodes of soap operas where
yes!
they go to the rave.
And there's kegs there.
Yeah, 90210, and they get dropped ecstasy
euphoria,
without even knowing.
It was euphoria.
That shit doesn't happen very often. Usually everybody's looking out for each other, for the most part.
Generally.
There's adults from your generation back.
I just want to get paid.
Pay attention.
I just want the money. I'm in it for the money. All the money.
How about you, Brad?
I do this for the girls.
Yeah.
No comment. And the money.
Girls and money.
Well, you guys aren't very good at
the classic
being interviewed.
Chicks,
Ryan,
beer, and money. Woo!
I'm cooking sausage.
I think this is... I totally want that to be on the front door tab. Because I'd be like, yes, I have arrived. I am my generation. And what's this with me being Generation X? I'm not Generation X. I'm just confused. Damn it.
Say it again.
Say it again. We do this because we want to and no other reason. And it's fun. And there's a bunch of people smiling and happy. And
so entertainment and
it's totally capitalistic entertainment. Hedonism at its finest moments. And, you know, if you can, like, groove with, like, 1,100 other people and sure. No one, like, gets into fights or anything, you know.
It's not stupid
everyone
as the hippie
like,
scene.
Yeah,
we opted out of the hippie scene, basically.
Okay, what you do is you take a deadhead and a disco freak and you mix them together and you got a raver. So.
What do you think about politics within the rave scene?
Oh,
do you think
politics,
there are any?
There are some. You just have to ignore it and just go and have fun. I don't know. Well, once you go, you start figuring out what parties you like and what parties you don't like. And once you know that, you go to those parties.
Well, do you think that it's a political statement going to a rave? At all?
I
you know, with the unity, peace, and harmony, do you think that has any truth
to
it at all?
I think that if we ever got our asses in gear and decided that we were going to be effective, yeah, it would have something to do with it. But, I mean, we just go out for a good time right now. Someday, I suppose, we'll be cool and throwing over the governments and stuff and taking over the world and, you know, rave culture will unite and cause peace, but that's the messianic era and, well, we all know about that. So, car at 12:30 to like 2 to get to Iowa City. From Iowa City, okay, then we left Iowa City around 4. 4 to 1. Yeah, no, we left Iowa City about 5. 5 to 1. So I was in a car for like 10 hours? Wow. 10 hours? I got arrested on the way for stealing an E out of a marquee and a Dairy Queen sign in Platteville, Wisconsin. The only reason they arrested me is because I have too many holes in my head and no hair. That's what I'm convinced of. Some asshole cop decided to bust me, and he wasn't even on duty. And the last thing he said before left, did I tell you the last thing he said before? He said, oh yeah, the ice cream's melting and the beer's getting cold, so I'm getting out of here. I'm like, you're such a prick. Anyway.
So
a $3 plastic E that's about this big cost me $175. So I was jailed. We might have that on footage.
Yeah, we do.
We have that. Well, just clips, you know. And, you know, that still didn't ruin my vibe. And I'm like,
jump from one clip over back.
Boom. Ah! And it still didn't ruin my vibe. And it actually kind of made it more humorous because you just realize how ludicrous the rest of the world is. And then you get to something like this and everyone's really cool. For you and not for anyone else. It's for us, I guess.
It's just a place to lose yourself in music.
Yeah.
So how long did you
get
drive here?
Drive here?
So how long took you to get
from
here?
From Platteville. I don't know. I think it was like 3 hours.
Yeah, for some reason it took
four
us like
hours.
A gazillion longer.
It wasn't four.
It was 4 hours.
No, because
well,
we left at like 8 or 8 and then we had to go to
speed
Madison.
Was 90 miles an hour.
I wanted to get here, okay?
Damn it, I was excited!
I don't know.
It's just a place that you cannot have to worry about Well, I have four papers in school due in the next 2 weeks, all of which are 10 to 12 pages long, and you just don't worry about that now. You're just here for having a good time. That's why everyone else is here.
And cook.
And cooking.
Cook sausage or toast and sausages.
Sausages. Of course, I'm not eating that because that's pork and it's nasty.
Why have you been going for as long as you have? What keeps you coming back? So,
go.
Yeah, just ask a question.
I had a cousin who, in the 60s, ran with the revolution and sat me down when I was like 12 years old and told me all about the books to read and the videos to watch and the records to listen to and everything like that. And I just knew, and I just knew that that was cool that they had that, but we needed something for ourselves. And when Acid House started, that's when I first got a taste of it, like back in Chicago. And then now with the raves, we've come a long way, and like it's just been a lot of fun, and it's just gonna go like bigger from here.
You think so?
Oh, I think it's gonna get huge.
You think you're a lot more optimistic then about it than a lot of other people are?
Okay. I think we're standing on on the brink of something really gigantic.
Why? What makes it gigantic? What's the big deal about it?
The people. I mean, it's the only thing in youth culture right now that's like positive. You know, it's not hip hop. It's not, you know, it's not like grunge. It's not the like, you know, everyone's woe is me. Fuck that shit. You know, it's like.
We better go.
We're supposed to play.
You're supposed to play.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are the potatoes done?
Tips are 10. All the single ones are 10.
Somebody tipped huge, I think.
There are 14. This is 10.
Would you like another potato?
Are 15.
No, it was for that Ray guy.
15, 14, 10.
I asked him for
I'm doing the
hold on. I got something for you. Homemade stickers.
Oh, cool.
But I'm running out. I've only got one girl, one left. This is the boy because it points up. You can have the fish.
Hey, Mew.
Wow. Thank you.
The fish.
Want to go get your face painted?
What? Yeah. It's right there. My sister's doing it, so. Go entertain me. Thanks.
Is this for TV?
No, she's gonna make a documentary on raves.
Oh, you want an interview?
Yeah, he was the host of Mitch's show that I was telling you about.
Oh, this is?
He was the host of
Mitch's TV show.
So why do you go to raves?
Why do I go to raves?
Educated answer.
Please. Well, here you can get cocaine and heroin here, so I'm looking out for it.
Hey man, you're cramping my style.
You think he has some? Next question.
He's got the music.
Okay,
is Anthony really a messed up guy or not?
What?
Is Anthony a truly messed up person or not? Tigger.
But look, it's clear enough though. We're gonna have stars.
See that guy over there, that's Pluto from Papa.
Kids.
You got the other Big Ten going. Points of interest.
Oh God!
What?
This is disgusting. I know I'm going to
all the merchandise is top notch. You don't have to pay taxes, it's just going to me and I'll hook you up.
Yeah. I do.
What? Oh, this guy here.
I'm not even a dancing person.